Well, hello everybody and welcome to what is the opening day of the 16th European Championships. 55 UEFA member states tried their hand at becoming the finest of them all, but now we are left with just 24 who have made it to these finals en route to Wembley. Opening day certainly has a special feel to it, the atmosphere combustible but joyous as we usher in a new era for this competition together with the hopes and aspirations of all that take part. Worth reminding ourselves too that 2020 is the 60th birthday of these championships, and it is for that special reason that the competition is being held right across the continent. There is nowhere quite like Anfield for its history, for its tradition, a place where so many of English football's most famous tales have been staged. Here it is then, the first page of the first chapter of this special tournament.
All I hope is that these nations, as well as the players of course, can make a good account of themselves. And I also like the fact that such excitement isn't just something that one host country has the monopoly of. It's shared by so many people across the continent, literally, and that certainly created an extra special buzz.
Away. Jim, who do you pick out as the telling individual today?
Yeah, Thiago Alcantara. He's someone who can really control a game from midfield. He's got a sensational range of passing. He's got wonderful vision too. He's no doubt been tasked with creating opportunities for the front players, and he certainly...
It's Morata! Good stop. That wasn't easy.
Morata is very sporting here to acknowledge the quality of the save. A lovely little footballing moment.
Gets it away. And it's Saul. Oh, shooting chance! He's missed, but not by that far.
Good effort, very good effort. He would have at least wanted to make the keeper work, though. Well, there's a lot of movement out wide now.
Yeah, you can certainly see that.
Well, I think it's a move to open the game up more, whether out wide or just getting a runner through the middle now.
Forsberg. Pings it out wide. Aimed in towards the centre. The defence can get it clear. It's been a good start to the game, and the underdogs are clearly keen to underline that they're not just here to make up numbers.
Seems like a brave decision, but the right one for me. The longer this goes on for, the more quality is likely to tell. If you're looking to unsettle this opposition, it has to be now.
Sergio Ramos goes looking.
Lost.
Sergio Ramos cuts it out. And here's Rodrigo. He gets past his man, Morata! Away from immediate danger.
And it's Rodrigo.
And a shot!
Well, that is rather wayward.
Well, Peter, I would say it was worth a try.
It'll be a throw-in. Isco. Granqvist. Claesson.
Sweden going about it patiently, perhaps too patiently. Ball needed to be better there, it's a wasted chance. Hoists it forward.
He's got options out wide.
Nicely controlled.
Rodrigo. And it's Saul.
Saul! Oh, that was no routine.
We hit half-time.
Both sides have drawn blanks. And have toiled at times, but it's not been a bad game by any means.
So there was the first half.
Spain really did turn up the tempo at the end of the half, and while they would be disappointed not to have broken through, obviously, the chances will come, provided they can keep producing good spells. It's been a half with significantly more positives than negatives, I feel.
Spain head to the dressing room, not yet having broken through. Tight, cagey game. Not a team any further forward than they were when they started out.
Just back from your break, you've missed very little of the resumption of the second half.
Spain playing well with lots of opportunities and plenty positives to take from the first half. Despite this scoreline, converting chances would make a world of difference for them.
He's making good use of his strength there, just refuses to be out-muscled.
Claesson
plays it back.
It's broken loose!
Now it's Morata. Saul.
He spotted the run and played it through.
Granqvist. Lindelof. Martinez, it is still anyone's game, 0-0.
Morata
with a really impressive run, which nearly went the whole way.
Oh, look, his determination needed to be greater than the obstacle he was faced with, and it wasn't.
Gets the better of his man.
And he's looking at the referee, but the referee is shaking his head.
And here's Morata.
Lindelof battles to win it back. Looks to clip it forward. Lovely bit of skill there.
Plenty waiting in the middle.
Claesson.
Oh, that's neat. Played out to the right. There's the ball in.
Sweden merit full marks for their attitude and application in trying to win this. It means an awful lot, obviously.
Now it's Morata. Out to the right.
Rodrigo.
Lovely bit of skill. They need to get it in quick.
Well, both sides might have to settle for a draw here, although there's still a chance for...
And that's it. Well, they've got a point. Three, of course, were preferable, but up and running for a new campaign. Your reflections then, Jim?
It could have been both better or worse, so a draw will be a happy compromise, I think, to open their group account. It always helps to have something to build on, and I think this will do nicely.